Hello and welcome to the first Salome Meca tutorial by LibreMechanics. In this video, you will find a useful, hello world, step-by-step example that will help you to understand how this platform works. Let's start by assuming you already have Salome Meca installed in your computer. If you don't, please refer to LibreMechanics webpage where you will find how to install in your system. If you are working in a Kali Linux platform, you already have Salome Meca installed on your system, you just may want to search how to start it. For this tutorial we will use a clean 2012.1 LGPL version of Salome Meca, which you can download from Coder's webpage. Let's start the program. In this case I run the program by this command on a console. The Salome Meca interface show up allowing us to start working. We will find a common program interface with analysis order tree. In this menu we find the interfaces of geometry, mesh, post-processing, and the solver's controls. Go to the geometry module and create a new work. You will find a tools bar, a 3D workspace and an object browser. In the 3D workspace you can create any geometry you want to analyze with the tools bar. For this tutorial we will use a simple 3D piston model. You can find this model in your CD media, or your hard drive, if you are using Kali Linux, or in LibreMechanics webpage if you don't have it. Click on File, Import. And then search for your 3D model. In this window you can import any kind of geometry that the program supports, then click Open. We will see that the piston appears on our object browser, so let's see it. A quick reference to the 3D view window. Right click, select. Middle wheel, zoom. Left click, menu. Control right click, zoom. Control middle button, power move. And finally control left click, 3D rotation. We will create a group of faces to define the macages and rest sessions on our analysis. For that click on new entity, groups and create. You can create a group of points, lines, faces and bodies. Let's select face and define a new name for our group. In the main shape field select the 3D piston model and then click on the arrow icon. This will take the name of the entity you have selected. Then you can select any face of the 3D model you want to assign in this group. Do the same thing for the next group. Let's go to the mesh module in our Salome Meca work tree. Here you will find a 3D workspace, the same object browser and a new tools bar for this module. Now let's create a new mesh for our 3D model. Go to Mesh and create a new mesh. Here you can create a mesh for any kind of geometry you want, 3D models, 2D model, 1D beams and special objects. Click on Assign a set of hypotheses on 3D window, then select 3D tetrahedralization. This will create an automatic 4 points elements in our 3D volume. Then in our object browser, left click on Mesh and Compute. A window with all the mesh properties must show up. Then, assign the old geometry groups to our new mesh like this. It is highly recommended that you save your work by this point. Now let's go to our Lister module and define the analysis type and all the properties. In this case, we will use the Linear's Elastic Study Assistant to get a fast example analysis. Here you can define the material properties. The degrees of freedom of a set of groups and loads. This will create a simple ASTA file that can be solved with the code ASTA solver. To run the analysis, just left-click on the study name and select Run. A terminal of ASTA Solver shows up working on the analysis. Then go to the post-processing module where we can see the results. And finally here you can try every kind of display that Salome Meca have for your results. Thanks for watching the first Salome Meca tutorial by LibreMechanics. You can find more information in the webpage www.libremechanics.com.